So this is the typical animal cell you can see on your screen. So typical animal cell, the different parts are shown over here. And this particular diagram, again, our picture I have taken from the Google. So you can find here, this one is the cytoplasm. So our main focus is the nucleus. So nucleus is present over here. And as I told you, nucleus is the double membrane structure. So inner membrane of the nucleus and outer membrane of the nucleus. So outer membrane of the nucleus, you can see here, this particular outer membrane, it is continuous to the endoplasmic reticulum. This is a very important point. Outer membrane of the nucleus, it is continuous to the membrane of the endoplasmic reticulum. So here you can see, this is a typical animal cell where the nucleus is there. This is the whole nucleus. Outside the nucleus, there are endoplasmic reticulum. So this endoplasmic reticulum, they are responsible for the synthesis of the proteins. So on the endoplasmic reticulum, there are some ribosomes are present over here. You can see over here, there are some dot-like structures. And these dot-like structures, these are the ribosomes. So ribosomes are present over here. And that ribosome plays an important role in the protein synthesis. Or simply we can say that endoplasmic reticulum and ribosome, they play an important role in the protein synthesis. Then you can find some other structures over here. For example, mitochondria is there, which is the organelle, which is responsible for the synthesis of the ATP molecules. Then here you can find there are some microtubules, intermediate filaments. These are the bones, we can say. These are the bones of the cell, we can say. They are going to support the cell. These are known as the filaments present inside the eukaryotic cell. And there are some other structures are there, peroxisome, centrioles, Golgi complex is there. So we are not going to discuss the functions or some important thing regarding all these organelles. We are just going to focus on the nucleus. The topic of discussion is the nucleus. So we have discussed about the nucleus. So nucleus, as I told you, some cells are there, my dear friends. Nucleus is present in the eukaryotic cell, but there are some exceptions also. For example, RBC, that is a red blood cell, which is the type of the eukaryotic cell. But inside the RBC, nucleus is not present. So RBC, they do not possess the nucleus. So they are responsible for the oxygen carrying. So inside the RBC, that is a red blood cell, hemoglobin is present and oxygen is attached to the hemoglobin, and this particular oxygen is carried to the different parts of the body. So on your screen you can see these are the red blood cells, and that red blood cell, it contains the only hemoglobin. There is no nucleus or no other cell organelles are present. There are only millions of hemoglobin proteins are formed, and oxygen is attached to the hemoglobin, and then that particular RBC, they travel with the help of the circulatory systems, and hemoglobin is carried with RBCs. So you can find over here, this one is the shape, this is the shape of the RBCs, the biconcave disc-like shape with no nucleus, and they are going to carry the oxygen. So these pictures are again I have taken from the Google, and these are some other type of the blood cells. That is the erythroblast are there, reticulocytes are there. These blood cells, they are having a nucleus. But when mature RBCs are formed, then they doesn't having nucleus. This is a very important point of discussion. So first we'll focus on the structure of the nucleus. So typically, it is the most evident organelle in the cell. Nucleus, it is the most evident organelle present inside the eukaryotic cell. And we have seen this point previously also. The nucleus, it is completely there, completely bound by the membrane, completely bound by the membrane. So you can see again the picture of the nucleus which I have taken from the Google. So this is the nuclear envelope, and you can clearly find nuclear envelope. It is the double membrane structure, and it contains the genetic material, that is the DNA and RNA. And here you can find these are the some nucleolus. Remember, nucleolus, it is not membrane bound. Only nucleus is the membrane bound animal. So inside there are some nucleolus which is not membrane bound, and we know the role of the nucleolus. It plays an important role in the ribosome synthesis, production of rRNA and different proteins. Again, these are the some beautiful pictures which I have taken from the Google. You can clearly find. Now here, this is a 3D pictures of the nucleus. You can see here inside there are nucleolus. You can see here this one, the nucleolus, which is not membrane bound structure. The chromatin thread, you can see here. These are the chromatin threads, which is the compact form of the DNA. Chromatin thread, or it is also known as a condensed chromatin. Chromatin means what? Chromatin is equal to DNA plus protein. So DNA present in a condensed form or compact form, we can say. Again, here this one is the nuclear envelope. This is the inner nuclear membrane, and this one is the outer nuclear membrane. And we can see here, these are the these are the nuclear pore. You can see here, this one is the nuclear pores. These are the small holes present on the nucleus, nuclear membrane. So nuclear pore, number of the nuclear pore, it is different from cell to cell. So number of the nuclear pore, it depend on the synthetic activity of the cell. How cell is active? If cell is very active synthetically, then number of nuclear pore it is increases. So there are number of nuclear pores are present, small hole we can say, and that is used for the transport purposes. And you can find here, these are the ribosomes, these are the ribosomes attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. And these ribosomes are synthesized inside the nucleolus. Again, this is the picture which I have taken from the Google, and this picture we have already learned. All the parts we have already learned, so we are not going to waste our time. You just find here, this is the perinuclear space, the space between outer membrane, outer nuclear membrane and inner membrane. That space is known as perinuclear space. Here there are different parts we have seen. This one is the nuclear lamin. Inside the nuclear membrane, there are some proteins are present, and these proteins, they are polymerized, that is they come together, and then they are going to form a nuclear lamina. And nuclear lamina, what is the function of the nuclear lamina? These chromatin threads, they are going to attach to the nuclear lamina. And nuclear lamina, they also going to protect the inner nuclear membrane by the digestion by the some enzymes present in the nucleus. And here you can find, this one is the DNA, which is the chromatin threads, which is the genetic material of the cell. And here this one is the ribosome. Again, these are the different pictures. Now you can, you will find, and you will try to explain for the different parts of the nucleus and functions of the nucleus. So the membrane that is distinguished, this particular nuclear membrane, they distinguish the cytoplasm from the nucleus. So the cell chromosomes are also confined within the nucleus. So here the chromosomes, they are present inside the nucleus. And chromosome means what? Chromosome means it is the DNA plus protein. Compact form of the DNA is known as the chromosomes. So DNA is present in the chromosomes, and they provide the genetic information required for the creation of different cell components in addition to the reproduction of the life. So this is the function of the nucleus. Okay, so we have discussed about the functions of the nucleus. Now, nucleus, it is one of the most important thing. Nucleus, it having a DNA. Sorry. So nucleus, it having a DNA. This is the most important thing. So we must understand what is meant by the DNA. DNA is known as the deoxyribonucleic acid. So in front of you, I have shown here I have given the picture of the DNA. So you can see here, this one is the DNA. And the DNA structure, it is a double helix structure of the DNA. We know that DNA is the polymer, which is made up of the nucleotides. Which nucleotides? You can see here, thymine, adenine, cytosine, and guanosine. So these particular nucleotides, they are made up of one nucleotide. For example, adenine, they are made up of the nitrogenous base, phosphate group, and sugars, ribose sugar, we can see here. So this is the three component of the nucleotides. So in the DNA, that thymine always pairs with the adenine, and cytosine, they always pairs with the guanine. So this is the basic rule. And this one is the hydrogen bond between the nucleotides, that is the thymine and adenine, and this particular thymine and cytosine, they are joined by the phosphodiester bond. So pyrimidine and purines, that is the adenine and guanine, these are the purines, and thymine and cytosine, these are the pyrimidines. So we can say that pyrimidines, they pairs with the purines same way. So this is the structure of the DNA, and we can see here, these are the grooves present on the DNA. You can see here, these are the grooves, minor groove and major groove. See here, these are the grooves. Means it is a depression. Marathi madhe jala apan khach manto, khach. So depressions present on the DNA, these are known as the grooves. So minor grooves are there, and you can see here, these are the major grooves and minor grooves. These are the grooves, depressions present in the DNA, which is needed for the attachment of the different proteins, different enzymes. They are going to attach over here for the replication, translation. So these grooves, they play an important role for the attachment of the proteins or attachment of the enzyme. So this is the double helical model of the DNA, and we know that this particular double helical model was first time put forward by the Watson and Crick, and they received the Nobel Prize for this particular double helical structure of the DNA in 1953. So this is a very important discovery by Watson and Crick. Again, this is the double helical structure of the DNA. You can see here, there are two strands. They come together and they join together by the hydrogen bond. This is the one strand which is shown in a blue color, and in orange color, it shows the another strand. So they come in a helical form, they twisted form. The two strands are twist together and they form a helical structure. So this is the helical structure of the DNA. So just I have shown what is meant by the DNA, and DNA is present inside the nucleus, and DNA act as a genetic material. which pass the information from parents to daughter. This is a very important function of the nucleus. And here, this is this particular adenine and guanosine. These are the purines, and thymine and cytosine. These are the pyrimidine. These are the nucleotides. Again, this is the structure of the DNA. This is the, you can see these are the strands of the DNA, and this is the sugar phosphate backbone. And inside there is a base, nitrogenous base are present. So the function of the nucleus we'll discuss again one by one. As I told you already, this particular nucleus, it restore or it store the hereditary information, and it control the cell growth, and cell reproduction is controlled by the nucleus. The nucleus, it is clearly explained as a membrane bound structure, and it store the genetic material for the cell. So nucleus is not just a compartment for the DNA, but it also happens to the home for some important cellular process. This is not just a home for the DNA, but it is also home for the some important cellular processes, such as the DNA replication, DNA transcription. So as I told you, DNA duplicate inside the nucleus, duplication, or it is also known as the DNA replication. So this process, as I told you already, the process has been named as a DNA replication. So it is produced the identical copies of the DNA. During the cell division, it produces identical copies of the DNA, and that process is known as the DNA replication, which takes place inside the nucleus. So this is the DNA replication form. This is a double-stranded DNA. First, it is converted into the single-stranded DNA, DNA unwind, and then DNA replication takes place. So here you can find this one is the leading strand, which synthesizes continuously. And here this is the lagging strand, which continues or discontinuously synthesizes. So these are the Okazaki fragments, that is the short fragments synthesized. And this is the Okazaki, this is the name of the scientist. And DNA synthesis, my dear friends, remember it is always takes place in 5 prime to 3 prime direction. See here, this is the end, 5 prime, these are the ends of the DNA. So DNA replication takes place only in a 5 prime to 3 prime direction. So the next function of the nucleus, nucleus is also the site of the transcription. Transcription, it is a process in which DNA material, it is copied into the RNA, and nucleus, it is again a site of the transcription. So here you can see, this is a double-stranded DNA, which is converted into the single-stranded RNA, and this process is known as the transcription. And this RNA, it is again converted into the polypeptide chain, and further that polypeptide chain, it is converted into the proteins. So the transcription, it created different types of the RNA from the DNA. We know that there are different types of the RNA. That is rRNA, which is also known as the ribosomal RNA. Then ribosomal RNA. Then tRNA, that is a transfer RNA. And there are so many other RNA, mRNA is also there, which is known as the messenger RNA. So the transcription, it is a very important process which create the many copies of the RNA, and they are going to produce the different proteins. So the central rule of the biology state that the DNA is copied into the RNA, and then it is converted into the protein. This process is known as the central dogma of molecular biology. So in this video, we have discussed about the functions of the nucleus. So thank you so much for the watching. Please like the video, share the video, and subscribe RMK Resolutions for more update. Bye bye.